Today we've travelled south from XYZ headquarters down to the English Riviera, and in particular to Paignton. Not renowned for being a hotbed of engineering, but it is where the headquarters of CSS Group are based, winners of the Queen's Award for International Trade. The manufacturers of the Versatote system, the boxes that transport parts and items all around the country. And the company manufacture a massive 1.3 million of these boxes every year. And we're here to meet James Head, the Managing Director, to find out all about the operation here and why they've invested in XYZ machine tools. So firstly, James, thanks for inviting us into CSS Group and your impressive new factory. Before we start talking about your relationship with XYZ and the machines you've got here, perhaps you could tell us a little bit about the group and the functions and activities that you take part in here.
So the group is consisted of three different companies, one of which is casting support systems, injection molding, technical composite systems, which makes composites parts for aerospace and defence, and the core of the business, which is investment casting systems, which is the tool making side of the business.
So I walked in this morning to this impressive facility. You've not long moved in here. How big is your facility?
So our new facility is 60,000 square feet plus offices.
Okay, and is that split equally between the three groups of companies that you have within the facility?
Relatively. So the injection molding side is half the facility. Technical composite systems is a sixth, and one third of it is the tool making.
Okay, and I know you've been doing tool making for a long, long time. Do you just make tools for your own injection facility here, or do you do it for other people as well?
So it's 44 years now. It's quite a while.
Long time.
So, yeah.
Yeah, long time.
So we do all our own injection mold tools for our large plastic bins, but we do an awful lot of mold tools for aerospace and defence, particularly for composites for the internals of aircraft and for the investment casting industry for aeroplane engine parts.
Oh, okay. So let's have a walk down to the main machining area within investment casting systems, and we can have a look at what products you've got here and what benefits you get from investing in XYZ.
Okay.
So as we walk up your facility here, James, we're coming up to what is effectively known as XYZ Alley.
That's correct.
I guess that's because of the amount of XYZ products you've got down in the machining area.
It is indeed, yeah. Six XYZs down this one row.
Okay. And I noticed that a lot of them are the 1060 HS machine. Is
correct.
There a particular thing about the HS 1060 from the XYZ range that appeals to you as an injection mold maker?
The 1060 was actually our first ever proper CNC machine.
Oh, okay.
And it was so good we ended up buying four of them. It's not just a good machine for accuracy, but it was very, very cost effective.
Okay. So have you still got your original machine, or have you superseded since then?
The very first machine has just been replaced by a new version of the 1060.
Ah, okay. So that gives us an opportunity. Let's walk down the alleyway and have a look at this new product that you've got from us. So then, James, you said you bought your first 1060 a number of years ago. What was it about that particular product that appealed to you and you thought it would fit the requirements you had within your facility here?
So back in 2008, when we bought the first 1060, the main reason for buying it was the footprint versus the working envelope and the cost effectiveness. All the options that you would have to buy on other people's machines came bundled into the machine, such as through head, coolant, etc.
Okay. So it was the specification that appealed to you then, rather than anything else.
Yeah.
And you've bought a number of them over the years. This one here is the latest incarnation that you've purchased. And I know that we're quite good at XYZ at listening to what our customers want. You know, we've always said our evolution of XYZ has come from listening to customers. And this product here is a result of things that you've suggested. So what were the sort of things that you wanted to see improved on the 1060 and has made you invest in this latest product?
So yeah, having used the machines for 15 years, having four of them, we were well placed to tell XYZ what we thought could be improved. And on the 1060, it was thermal growth. There was a little bit of thermal growth, which in the industries we're working was slightly too much. So we suggested some improvements. XYZ have listened, they've produced this machine, promised zero growth, and we've got zero growth.
Oh, and how have you checked that then? How have you been able to quantify that what we've said has actually happened?
We've run the spindle at 15,000 RPM, tested it for 24 hours with measuring devices on the machine, and got no discernible growth in the Z or the Y axis.
That's certainly a very impressive thing. So maybe it's the change of design that we've gone through here, because I might be stand corrected here, but your original machines had 12,000 RPM. We've now gone up to 15,000 RPM, yeah, but with an inline spindle. And so that's possibly the change that's happened to design that gives you these improvements.
Correct, that is, yeah.
So that's probably relevant to you, because I know you've told me in the past that the cycle times of some of the tools you make, what finishing cycle times are in the region of?
It can be up to about 24 hours on a 1060. Yeah.
Okay, so and you're running at high speeds for the majority of that?
Yeah, so some of the tools go down to half a millimeter diameter, so we can be running at maximum revs.
Oh, that's quite an impressive. How do you know whether the tool's actually broken?
That's why we've got the Renishaw probing.
Ah, right, okay. So you said earlier about, you know, the specification of the machine was already pretty high for you. Any options that you've had fitted to the machine that's not on our standard spec?
As mentioned, it's the only thing that wasn't on the original specification was the Renishaw probing for tools and measuring of parts.
Okay. So the improvements we've made to this latest model is, as I've already mentioned, the inline spindle at 15,000 RPM. We've increased the number of tools on the carousel, so that gives James and his team here more opportunity to keep tools ready to go when they're machining their mold tools, etc. It's already got linear roller bearings on the axes there, direct drive at the end of the ball screw, and an impressive 43 metres a minute of rapid traverse. So I'm guessing, James, all these things add up to you being as productive as you possibly can when you're making your tools.
I don't believe that for the money you can buy a better machine tool.
Oh, that's certainly a great endorsement. One of the other things I want to ask you about is, because of the type of work you do, I see a lot of customers using CAD/CAM to generate the programs to run and manufacture mold tools. Yep. Is that the way you operate here at Casting Support Systems?
Predominantly, yes, for the more complex forms, but for the simpler forms such as pocketing, etc., it's so easy to use the Siemens control, we'll do it on the control.
Okay, so can all your guys here program on board on the machine as well then?
Yep, all of our guys have been trained at XYZ.
So in summing up then, James, this latest 1060 that you've had from XYZ, with its inline spindle, its cooled spindle jacket, chilled ball screws, linear roller bearings, what benefits are you actually seeing and productivity gains are you actually getting from purchasing this machine?
So we're obviously able to spin smaller tools, so some areas that would have been sparked are now being machined. The surface finish we're getting from the machine is greatly improved, so polishing has been greatly reduced. And also we've been able to change machining strategies because we've got more confidence in the machine is going to do what we want it to do. Therefore we can actually do greater cuts and change the finishing strategies and actually shortens the time on the machine.
Okay, so it sounds like this machine's been a win-win all round for you in every aspect, not just machining itself, but some of the other add-on things that you do here to make your tools themselves.
Correct.
So James, thanks for your time. We really appreciate you telling us all about your 1060s and what you do here at CSS Group. So thank you very much for your time.
You're very welcome.
James is obviously seeing big benefits from investing in this 1060 machine. If you'd like to know more about this product or any of the others in the XYZ range that could give you productivity gains in your business, contact XYZ by using the details on the screen.